textile and craft expert Gina Tepper is joining us now to show how you can jazz up your Thanksgiving table, and you have some fabulous ideas.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Let's start with the wine bottles.
Okay. You know, the one thing I feel like, if your table is beautiful, no one's going to remember that the mashed potatoes were cold or the turkey was dry, so make it look beautiful.
If they have enough wine, they won't remember anything.
Right. That's true. So I like to decorate wine bottles. I like everything to look pretty.
Pretty.
So this is actually really easy. You can see this just comes right off. This is scrapbooking paper, and I just wrapped it around. And then you just use burlap. You can see this. I wrapped it around here.
Can you just get it in a craft store?
Yeah, and it's really inexpensive. And
a little hot glue?
Yeah, or you can even, glue, any kind of craft glue, fray the edges. And then you can just glue a leaf right on there.
Look at that. How simple is that?
And it's so pretty. And then you know what I like to do? I like to take the corn husks, and you just rip off the ends.
Yep.
And then you fray, if you just fray them like this.
Just break them apart like
just
that?
Fray them. And it's kind of fun to
do.
That's
great.
Like
fun.
That.
Oh, the
and
kids will love this.
And then you do it, and then you put them on top, and it just... It looks really pretty.
And you've got a little ribbon on top there to jazz up the top of it.
It's fun.
Take a look at these glasses that you've made. You actually beaded the bottoms of them.
I did. I love these.
How easy.
These I actually got at the dollar store.
The glasses?
The glasses. And look at them. Now you look like something fancy that you would buy at a nice store.
And you just took beads like these and glued them on there?
Glued them on. But you need a really strong glue because you want to be able to wash them. These aren't going to be able to be put on the dishwasher because the beads might come off.
So a strong glue like what?
A strong glue. Like I used a silicone glue. I went to the hardware store. And something that works in a fish tank is really good because, even though it's not going to be in a fish tank, it's going to work.
Right, but at least it would stay.
So I glued them on and I used those little, I put the big beads on. And you can use old costume jewelry or whatever you have. And then use those little seed beads and just sprinkle them on. And then it looks beautiful.
These are neat.
The mismatched glasses and something.
Your leaves up front. I thought they were real.
I know. It looks like we should be raking them.
You made them out of pages from a dictionary.
Yeah, look at this. This is fun. Now, I went to this craft store at Historic Savage Mill, which I love that place. And they have this specialty craft store called Queen's Ink. And I took a class there and I learned about this spray ink. Basically what you do is you just, I actually used a real leaf for the pattern. So you can cut, you can get some real leaves and then cut out from a dictionary, newspaper, spray some water, spray this ink. And it just blends and it dries really quickly. This is something fun to do with the kids, but look at this. And then you can just take a pencil and just curl the edges a little bit.
And that's how you get them to look curly.
And then it looks like, this is a real leaf from my yard. And this is, look at that.
That's perfect. Listen, I got made fun of when I said we were going to make napkin rings out of toilet paper rolls.
I know.
But you did it.
I know. Well, I use a paper towel because since it's a food item, I won't say the toilet paper
rolls. Oh, okay. All right. Paper towels. That works too.
Yeah.
Okay. So but you cut them up small.
Yes. And then I just, the width of a ribbon. And then you just wrap it around.
And this is ribbon with some wire to it.
Yes. I like that. Oh, you don't have to, but I like the ribbon with the wire. And then also here's one right here.
Right there in the front?
Yeah.
See, it's so you get your napkin right there just like that. Oh, that's so pretty and easy. This is something you did using twigs from the backyard.
Yeah, I did. I just went in the woods after the storm and found some twigs, and I came back and was like, what is she doing with a big stack of twigs? But I took the kids, and it was fun, and I just put them in there and glued some leaves, and then I bought these little tiny gourds at the dollar store and did them gold. And then I used Halloween lights for putting the jack-o'-lantern.
Because they're orange.
Yeah, and I put the ribbon around because you can see right here it's still orange.
A way to jazz up your existing centerpiece.
Exactly.
Make it more holiday-ish.
And then you still have pumpkins left over from Halloween. So I like the bathroom to look really pretty. So when they go in there, they see something pretty. So I put a scented candle. And then I decorated this with glitter glue and leaves. And
so you just glued your pumpkin to look gold.
Yeah.
Oh, that's so pretty.
Put this in the powder room and it looks really people walk in and they say, oh, Thanksgiving.
Again, another use for your paper towel holders.
Yeah,
you've glued feathers on here with your pumpkins.
This is fun to do with the kids when the turkey's cooking. But don't let them know that you're cooking something that, used to be alive running around.
They don't need to think about all that. But what they will like are your cookies over here and your horn of plenty that you have again decorated. Looks so beautiful. Gina Tepper, thank you so much for joining us. Beautiful ideas. And for more information, you can go to Gina's website. Her head is bursting with craft ideas. It is ginatepper.com. The time right now.